Yeah.
Could we have a person like Sanders who doesn't appeal to religion at all? And here's a video clip.
A moment ago, you said, God forbid. You say you're culturally Jewish. You don't feel religious. Do you believe in God, and do you think that's important to the people of the United States?
I am who I am, and what I believe in, and what my spirituality is about, is that we're all in this together. That I think it is not a good thing to believe that as human beings we can turn our backs on the suffering of other people. That we should not be living. And this is not Judaism. This is what Pope Francis is talking about, that we cannot worship just billionaires and the making of more and more money. Life is more than that. That we are living in a nation today which has seen a proliferation of millionaires and billionaires, massive income and wealth inequality. And you know what? We have the highest rate of childhood poverty of any major country on earth. We are the only major country on earth that doesn't guarantee health care to all people as a right. The only country that doesn't have paid family and medical leave. Many other countries are providing free tuition in their public colleges and universities. So essentially what I think is we do best as human beings. We fulfill our lives when we work together rather than say, hey, I want it all and I don't care about the hungry kid down the street. I don't think that's what America should be about.
Now, he also said, or there's something else here I read about him. It says, occasionally you'll hear folks speculate that Bernie Sanders is an atheist because he rarely talks about his religious views. Well, here's a rare glimpse of him speaking directly on this subject, published in September 19th of 2015 from Burlington Free Press. And this is what the story said. Sanderson doesn't generally speak about his own religious views. He said he's proud to be Jewish, and though he's not much into organized religion, he wouldn't be doing what he is today if he were not spiritual. And he says, quote, I believe that there is a connection between all living things and that my belief in God requires me to do all that I can to follow the golden rule, to do unto others as I would have them do unto me, he said. As a public servant, it requires me to do all that I can to ensure that every person lives with dignity and security. So what do you think about all that?
Well, I think he's got the basic premise right. He's got the Judeo-Christian principles right down to the T, and I think he speaks about it. My disagreement with Sanders is not on that. My disagreement with him is that I don't think he agrees with the natural law. He just says this is the law, but he doesn't go further into the natural law. And I disagree with him because he's a socialist, and socialism has never been known to work. In fact, countries like Denmark are abandoning socialism. China is abandoning socialism.
What is the natural law? You say he doesn't know the natural law. What does that mean?
Well, the natural law is what they talk about in the. I don't think he understands. Natural law would include things like abortion, things like family structure, things like that. I think because if you look at the definition of natural law is the things that, you know, it's what you would appeal to as an atheist. You say, look, if I do X, Y, Z and disease results, then I should not do X, Y, Z, right? We're not obligated to the natural law, but we have to understand the natural law.
So what does he not understand about natural law when it comes to abortion, for example?
Well, I think he believes that the fetus is not human, and everything that we have within our scope of understanding would say the fetus has its own DNA. It's not part of the woman's body, because if it was part of the woman's body, how come she has two heads, male and female genitals, if she's carrying a baby boy, right? And you can go down the line. It has its own blood type. Sometimes the blood type is completely different from the mother's. In fact, if the blood type is mixed, the mother, the child could die. It's got its own, you know, so you can go down all that stuff. It's a unique individual. So he abandons that in favor of saying, well, for convenience, I'm going to let women kill their baby, right? So these are these different arguments. I don't think he understands the natural law when it comes to the sin nature of man, right? The reason that we have a separation of powers in the Constitution is because the founders understood that men were inherently sinful, that, you know, we would try to take power for ourselves. So I think he rejects that in many cases. He wants more power in the government's arm rather than less. I think he also ignores that when it comes to socialism. Socialism is based on the principle that every man works as hard as he can and only takes what he can. Now, there are mortifications to that. People say, no, and they'll try to modify it. But basically, socialism is you work as hard as you can and you take what you need. But the reality is people will work as only as hard as they need, and they'll take as much as they can. Socialism bankrupts itself.
Which would disappoint you more, Bernie Sanders being the president or Hillary Clinton?
Oh, it'll all disappoint me. I don't know.
the same to you, pretty much?
I'd have to think about it. I never thought about it because I didn't think he has a chance in purgatory of being the nomination.
Okay. Now, what about, let's say, Hillary versus Trump? Would you much prefer Trump?
I would be forced to vote for Trump. Yeah, you always vote for the lesser of two evils. I mean, as I tell my Christian friends, look, if
Obama
was running against Hitler, I would vote for Obama, obviously, right?
So you would prefer would you prefer every single GOP candidate now running instead of Hillary, or do you think Hillary is better than some of the GOPs?
No, there's a strategic argument you could make that it would be better to have a bad Democrat than a bad Republican, because then people will realize their mistake. But I know I think I would.
But how?
I'd have
but
to
how?
You're right. I would say a bad Republican is better than a bad Democrat.
Well, I don't see how that logic would work, because they're president for 4 years, and so what are you proving?
Yeah. Well, it would be proved that Christians should get more involved. But yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm not saying that I don't agree with that. I think it would be bad.
Okay.
I think a bad Republican would be bad, but it would be not as bad as Hillary.
Okay, so we got 3.5 minutes left. Let's talk about Hillary Clinton.